Well, good morning, everyone. I hope you are doing well today on this beautiful Tuesday as we are gathered here for our morning devotions. It is great to be with you again. God be praised that He has given us this method, this means by which we can communicate even though we are apart. So without any further ado, why don't we continue our gathering in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, singing our morning praise. Holy God, fill us this day with new breath, and we shall be living words of praise. Sing your joy, proclaim God's glory, rise and sing, the morning has come. Bless our God and praise all creation, song of the earth and light from heaven, God is alive. Alleluia. All the earth is filled with rejoicing, light and life, the wonder of God. Christ has triumphed, risen forever, joy of our hearts and hope of our dreaming, God is alive. Alleluia. May we learn to become your kingdom. May we be your kindness and truth. Love is our calling, gift of your presence, children of God and Spirit of Jesus, God is alive. Alleluia. Light our way, O God of the living. May we learn to see with new eyes. Jesus the Lord, our power and promise, light for the blind and food for the hungry, God is alive. Alleluia. Amen. Our devotion for today is grounded in around the book of Hebrews chapter 4, excuse me, Hebrews chapter 9. Beginning with verse 24, where the apostle writes, "For Christ has not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are copies of the true, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. Not that he should offer himself often, as the high priest enters the most holy place every year, with blood of another, then he would have had to suffer often since the foundation of the world. But now, once at the end of the ages, he has appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself, and as it is appointed for men to die once, but after this the judgment, so Christ was offered once to bear the sins of many. To those who eagerly wait for him, he will appear a second time, apart from sin, for salvation." Wow, what a great passage. Absolutely love the book of Hebrews. And today we're going to talk about this one offering as another meditation or devotion on comfort, something that we all need during this time. Because you see, in many, maybe even in all disasters, in all situations, including this particular pandemic, there are sacrifices. There is, of course, the unwilling loss of possessions. There's the unwilling loss of our jobs, the unwilling loss of life. But even in such circumstances, people involve many willing and people involved willingly risk their lives and even sacrifice themselves for others. For example, a husband loses his wife in an attempt to protect his wife and family. A mother dies shielding her children from storms. Even young children have tried to protect their brothers and sisters. Even more familiar are the stories of sacrifice on the part of emergency personnel. Through storms and their aftermath, in piles of carnage, and I'm thinking of a tornado where there's all kinds of debris, rescuers will risk their lives. They'll risk their safety, not for their loved ones, but for strangers. Today, in our current pandemic, in our current situation, we have emergency workers, emergency personnel, doctors and nurses, who literally are on the front lines, risking their lives, not for their ones that they love, but for perfect strangers, people they don't even know. And so as we pray for our own safety and as we pray for the ones that we love, I think it's really incumbent upon us to also pray for those whose task it is to save and to bring aid to others. Sacrifices such as these that happen willingly, happen selfishly, made for the sake of others, are a picture of the single sacrifice that provided for us an eternal rescue. You see, in the pandemic called sin, and in the eternal death that swept over us, there was no shelter, there was no safer at home order in which we could hide, in which we could get away. But Jesus our Lord, the very one who stilled the storm of the Sea of Galilee, he didn't still this storm or turn it away from us, but what he is doing instead, that in our place, he stepped into the overwhelming respiratory problem of death for us. He stepped into this pandemic for us, took our place for us, and he allowed that pandemic to sweep over him. He allowed it to do its worst to him. The psalmist writes, "The snares of death encompass me, the pangs of Sheol lay hold on me. I suffered distress and anguish." There was no rescue for Jesus as the pandemic of our sin and death crushed him. Yet there is a rescue for us, a willing offering, one offering. Jesus himself took onto himself the penalty of death that you and I deserve. Then on the third day after his death, Jesus rose from the grave. The Lord of the winds and the waves, as at his command, he said, "I lay down my life of my accord, and I take it up again." Problems that we are enduring in this earthly life today, this coronavirus that is wreaking havoc with our world, in our world, may steal our convenience, may steal loved ones and family members from us, may cause us harm. But the eternal pandemic of death cannot overpower us now. You see, through Jesus' death and resurrection, and through faith in his name, you and I have forgiveness of our sins, a certain hope of eternal life, and an eternal shelter in his presence. Talk about an incredible safer at home order. We will be safer at home when we're at home with Jesus our Lord. And so as his redeemed people, we are called to offer ourselves to others as our Lord offered himself up for us. Not that we could take our that our lives would be a substitute for other people's sin, but rather that we would step into the gap to help one another. Jesus himself said, "I appeal to you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship." You see, even those who have experienced loss may sacrifice what they can by helping their neighbors in need, by sharing food, by giving comfort. And there is a willing sacrifice, an offering, if you will, that we can share. And that is crying out to God in the midst of loss or in relief that a disaster has left behind. I pray that our Lord keeps us safe. I pray that our Lord will watch over us and protect us as he promised he would. And as we go to the Lord in prayer, I'm reminded of the psalmist who said in Psalm 141, "Let my prayer be counted as incense before you, and the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice." Remember, our Lord sacrificed himself for us. And now he has called us to do the same. He has called us to go to those of us who are well, who are able, to go to those who are lonely, who are alone, who may be in need, and offer to be of help to them. Yes, even potentially to sacrifice, put ourselves in harm's way so that they don't have to be, just as Jesus did for you and me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go to the Lord in prayer, shall we? And as we pray, I ask you to remember, later today I'm going to be making a video before I get to our prayers. I'm going to be making a video about the National Day of Prayer that is coming up a week from Thursday. A week from Thursday. So that is in, 9 days? And so I'm going to be putting together a video for you all, and I'll be sending that out as an appeal to join with me and with countless others for a time of fasting and prayer. But I just wanted you to know that about that that's coming, to be on the lookout for it. Check your email inbox by tonight. It should be there. All right. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Lord Jesus, by your death and your resurrection, you rescued us from this deadly pandemic of sin and death. And in you we have the promise of shelter. We have the promise of being safe at home in your presence, now and for all eternity. Shield us, we pray, and shield us always with your mighty power, so that our faith will not waver, however strong the assaults of this pandemic may be upon us and upon our community and state. Strengthen us, dear Lord, through your word and through your supper, that we in turn can help others in need and offer up on their behalf the sacrifice of prayer in your name. Lord, I pray for those who are in need, dear Lord, this day, those who are in dire need, those who are looking to you, dear Lord, for help. And I ask you, dear Lord, that you would come to their aid, that you would provide for them in whatever situation they find themselves. Lord, I ask that if they need food, that you would provide people willing to step into the gap and provide food for them. If they need rides to go to the doctor or anything else for that matter, that would be provided as well. Whatever the case may be, Lord, I pray that you would help us to be the church, to be the church to everyone who is in need. Most especially, dear Lord, I pray for our farmers, dear Lord, who are starting to get out into the fields and prepare the soil for sowing. And I ask you, dear Lord, that you keep them safe. Lord, that you would, as I prayed for others, would prepare the way for them. Lord, that this, I pray for a bountiful harvest for them. That food would be the result for our country, for our world, so that no one ever dare go hungry. Lord, I also pray, dear Lord, for those who are without work, that you would continually provide for their needs according to your riches and glory. I pray for those, dear Lord, who are being challenged by the fact that they have to remain home, that are dealing with bouts of loneliness, where isolation is getting the better of them. And Lord, I ask that you would reassure them of your presence, that your ever-present presence, that you're always with us, no matter where we are, no matter where we go. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Lord, for your promise that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. Lord, I also ask for your prayers for Sharon, who has been diagnosed with Parkinson's disease. Lord, that is a nasty disease, and I pray, dear Lord, that you would bring comfort to her and to her family as they watch and as they wait. Lord, that you would give the doctors wisdom in their diagnosis and in their treatment of Sharon. And as this disease begins to manifest itself, Lord, I pray that it would be easily managed. Lord, you know the cry of our heart. You know the needs of our body and soul. And I ask you, dear Lord, to provide for it all. Keep us safe this day, we pray. For Jesus' sake, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please join me as we pray Luther's morning prayer. I thank you, my heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings and life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. And now let us confess our common Christian faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Well, I pray that the Lord richly blesses you and encourages you this day, that he will show himself to you to be your provider, your comforter, that your shelter in time of need, your shelter in the midst of the storm. So, as always, please make a comment down below that you're here. I'd appreciate that. I do keep track of those things, and as does Facebook. Interestingly enough, they track that information as well in terms of numbers, and not that it does anything for us, but it's just kind of fun to see what kind of reach we're having. And by the way, these broadcasts are being seen and viewed on a regular basis all the way back to regions in the country of Poland and also Russia. We have some Christian brothers there who are chiming in when they can. And so this is having far-reaching impact, not just across the street or across town, but across the world. So God be praised for that. And so may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit bless you now and always. Have a wonderful day in the Lord. Go in peace.